Kiki Aru, who had remained unnoticed in the shadow of the rock, was at first more alarmed by the coming of the strangers than even Ruggedo was, and the boy told himself that unless he acted quickly and without waiting to ask the advice of the old gnome, their conspiracy was likely to be discovered and all their plans to conquer and rule Oz be defeated. Kiki didn't like the way Ruggedo acted either, for the former king of the gnomes wanted to do everything his own way, and made the boy, who alone possessed the power of transformations, obey his orders as if he were a slave. Another thing that disturbed Kiki Aru was the fact that a real wizard had arrived, who was said to possess many magical powers, and this wizard carried his tools in a black bag, and was the friend of the Oz people, and so would probably try to prevent war between the beasts of the forest and the people of Oz. All these things passed through the mind of the Hyup boy while the Cowardly Lion and Gugu the King were talking together, and that was why he now began to do several strange things. He had found a place near to the point where he stood, where there was a deep hollow in the rock. So he put his face into this hollow and whispered softly so he would not be heard, "I want the Wizard of Oz to become a fox, Pirzqxgl." The wizard, who had stood smilingly beside his friends, suddenly felt his form change to that of a fox, and his black bag fall to the ground. Kiki reached out an arm and seized the bag, and the fox cried as loud as it could, "Treason! There's a traitor here with magic powers!" Everyone was startled at this cry, and Dorothy, seeing her old friend's plight, screamed and exclaimed, "Mercy me!" But the next instant the little girl's form had changed to that of a lamb with fleecy white wool, and Dorothy was too bewildered to do anything but look around her in wonder. The Cowardly Lion's eyes now flashed fire. He crouched low and lashed the ground with his tail, and gazed around to discover who the treacherous magician might be. But Kiki, who had kept his face in the hollow rock, again whispered the magic word, and the great lion disappeared, and in his place stood a little boy dressed in Munchkin costume. The little Munchkin boy was as angry as the lion had been, but he was small and helpless. Ruggedo the gnome saw what was happening and was afraid Kiki would spoil all his plans, so he leaned over the rock and shouted, "Stop, Kiki, stop!" Kiki would not stop, however. Instead, he transformed the gnome into a goose, to Ruggedo's horror and dismay. But the hungry tiger had witnessed all these transformations, and he was watching to see which of those present was to blame for them. When Ruggedo spoke to Kiki, the hungry lion knew that he was the magician, so he made a sudden spring and hurled his great body full upon the form of the Limon Eag crouching against the rock. Kiki didn't see the tiger coming because his face was still in the hollow, and the heavy body of the tiger bore him to the earth just as he said, "Pirzqxgl," for the fifth time. So now the tiger, which was crushing him, changed to a rabbit, and relieved of its weight, Kiki sprang up and, spreading his eagle's wings, flew into the branches of a tree where no beast could easily reach him.